Let's continue talking about soy. A few words about full fat technology. The first and most important step is to prepare the raw material, to dry and clean the soybeans from impurities. From the feeding hopper, the raw material enters the dehuller mill. Here, soybeans are compressed between the first pair of rollers. As a result, the shells burst and the soy kernels break up into several parts. A high protein mixture of soy kernels and hulls moves to the feeding system and air separator. Soybean shells have a light specific weight, and that's why airflow moves husks up and outputs them through the cyclone. While soybean kernels are discharged from the air separator, as a result, this process reduces the amount of fiber and increases the protein content in soy meal. Further, soybean kernels are loaded into the extruder. Inside the extruder barrel, the feedstock is compressed, heated, and crushed. The soy kernel is processed in less than 30 seconds. Under great pressure and high temperature, the amount of harmful substances and microorganisms in the product is reduced. Oil cells are revealed. Protein and fats do not lose their properties. However, the product's temperature is above 100 degrees now. That's why, to preserve the quality of the proteins, full-fat soy must be cooled. For this, we use a cooler. The rotating drum of the cooler pours the product towards the discharge, and in 10 to 15 seconds, the temperature of the full fat decreases to the ambient temperature, and the full fat is ready for storage. I hope you've learned something new about full fat technology and soybeans in general. Thank you for watching. Leave your comments and suggestions for future videos down below. Thumbs up and subscribe to Easy Extrusion channel. Easy Extrusion, as easy as it can be.